Madam Speaker, members of the House, today, like every day during the month of February of our session, we pause to say salute to the courage and even beyond the bravery that Blacks have embodied along life's journey in this Commonwealth and nation. It has yielded a paradox of emotions as we deal with the past that in every way fuels our future. It is plagued by a repertoire that ranges from catastrophe to triumph. We are all faced with this very fundamental question of, on this President's Day, what does it mean to be human? Much of our story in America has been sanitized and deodorized and has not spoken truth to power with a sense of parhesia that we all deserve. And so we boldly declare in unison, the God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us thus far along the way, thou who has by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. Today we reflect on the life of an unyielding, unflinching prisoner of hope and justice, the late Moses Grandy. You see, he was like so many other Blacks searching for freedom here in Virginia and North Carolina. At the tender age of 8 years old, and I think many of us can identify with that because we have children and grandchildren of our own, but imagine their little frail bodies. Well, Grandy was made a slave to his childhood playmate. Imagine the sense of betrayal that this child really felt. For it was his playmate that inherited him as his own when his father, the slave master, died in the early 1760s. Grandy went on to grow up around the city of Elizabeth City, North Carolina. And as he was used to be a slave as a part of labor, to support the Washington Company in the digging, draining, and developing of the Great Dismal Swamp Canal. And yes, it was appropriately named for its 100 degree plus temperatures, mosquitoes, bears, swampland, dangerous snakes, animals, and harsh conditions. But Moses Grandy, like many other slaves, some say more than 50,000, were found there as they hid as a part of the Underground Railroad, trying to find their freedom. Hopefully, as the Commonwealth's leaders, we can tell the plain truth about this place. Madam Speaker, members of the House, Moses Grandy was a part of the Washington Logging Waterway Company to help move products along the Elizabeth City, North Carolina route to Norfolk and beyond. They were the original longshoremen. However, there was no collective bargaining for their fair wages. Madam Speaker, members, as it's been well documented, this was the company of George Washington, our nation's first president. But even under the harshest of terms, Grandy was determined to be free. And I think it was Henry Wadsworth Longfellow in 1942 who wrote about this dismal place of habitat in his poem titled The Dismal Swamp. And he said, I quote, "And the wild birds fill the echoing air with songs of liberty." While working as a slave, his childhood friend would set aside for him earnings beyond the contract of his labor as requested by Grandy. He eventually made an agreement that once saving $600, he'd be allowed to buy his freedom. But sadly, an attitude of indifference persisted among slave owners, and it has been said that the indifference is more insidious and evil than evil itself. I happen to agree. You see, Moses Grandy was met with the saddest word in the English language, almost. Members of the House, that led to Grandy being swindled out of his money and was sold to another owner and remained in slavery. he almost made it. In latter years, he negotiated his freedom once again. So, Madam Speaker, members of the House, I presume you asked the question, how does virtue respond in the face of brute force? Well, Moses Grandy was able to save up another $600 to purchase his freedom. And again, he almost made it. He was sold as a slave, and the slave owner kept Grandy's money again. But Grandy shared a paradigm with Samuel Beckett that suggested that one should try again, fail better. He mustered up enough will and courage to buy his freedom a third time for $650, and he became forever free. Madam Speaker, members of the House, Moses Grandy truly understood that freedom is not free. He also understood, like poet laureate Amanda Gorman, that what just isn't always justice. Moses Grandy later moved north to cement his freedom and went on to purchase the freedom for other family members. And today, there's a small local roadway that connects a road from Chesapeake City Hall to a portion of the Dismal Swamp Canal named in Moses Grandy's honor. And the rest is history that we need to make allowance for. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, Chairman Hayes.